couple of people wrote me and asked if I would sing this next song. I love Civil War history. I just love it. And my dad and I kind of shared that, you know, love of it. We trade books back and forth, like that was our thing. And so when I was on Sony Classical, they didn't really know what to do with me. They were very nice, but you know, I'm kind of hard to pigeonhole. But they thought, well, you're very cinematic. Why don't you write some songs for movies? And you know, we can't guarantee you'll get in, but you know, we can bring it to the director, and you know, you never know. So I saw they were doing a Civil War film, and I found out it was Gods and Generals. And so I reread the Jeff Sharon novel, and I thought, I'm gonna try this, because I thought, I wanna try to write a song that would sound like it had been written in that era. You know, kind of like a Stephen Foster song. You know Stephen Foster, he wrote those beautiful songs like Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair, and he was sort of the pop songwriter of the Civil War era. So, so I set to work on it, and I also wanted to write a real soldier song, you know, because that's what the book was about, basically. And I wanted to capture the inner longings of the main characters. And I think a real soldier song at the end of the day is about home. It's about wanting to go home and dreaming of home. And I got the song done, and then promptly found out that Bob Dylan had gotten the gig. So it's like, well, I don't have a chance in hell, you know. And so I thought, well, what the heck, I'll give it to him anyway, and you never know. And so I made the simplest, rawest demo, you know, no fancy stuff on there, and gave it to Sony. And they told me that, you know, they'd already had the music and everything else, but they played it for the director, Ron Maxwell. And they said it was in a very sterile conference room up in the Sony building. And he sat there and they put it on, and they said he got up and he walked to the speaker and he put his hand on the speaker and his other hand on his heart. And he said, she really gets this. And so he put it in the movie. Yeah. Put my song at the beginning, and then Bob's song at the end.
Yes!
Not that it did me, the beads are good, but you know. But anyway, the movie did not do well, but in fact it tanked. In fact, it tanked so badly I've never seen a movie tank the way that movie tanked. But I get, you know, I don't know why they must show the movie in bases overseas, because I get quite a few letters from servicemen and women around the world in these god-awful forsaken places. Afghanistan, and, you know, Iraq, these foreign names, you know, and they say that it helps them, you know, it soothes them in some way. And it always makes me feel like, well, my song may not have been, you know, an Academy Award winner, but if it can help some young guy fall asleep at night and feel better about things, then that makes me feel like it was worth it, you know? It really does. So I'm gonna sing this song for you. They say there's a place where dreams have all gone. They never said where, but I think I know. It's miles through the night, just over the dawn, on the road that we'll take.
lost and all that we've won, and this road finally takes.